In this example, we use bond energies to approximate the change in enthalpy for a reaction. Our problem reads, calculate the change in enthalpy for the reaction below, as written, using the bond energies provided. Use the best Lewis structure for each molecule. In OSF4, the oxygen and all four fluorine atoms are bonded to the central sulfur atom. We can approximate the change in enthalpy for a reaction as the enthalpy change to break all the bonds of the reactants and the enthalpy change to form all the bonds of the products. Breaking bonds always requires energy, so the enthalpy change is positive. Forming bonds releases energy, so the enthalpy change is negative. So our equation is the change in enthalpy for a reaction is the summation of the enthalpy changes for bonds broken, subtract the summation for enthalpy changes of bonds formed. If we're breaking all the bonds of the reactants and forming all the bonds of the products, we'll need the best Lewis structure for each substance in the reaction. Let's start by breaking all the bonds of the reactants. In our balanced chemical equation, we have two SF4 molecules, and each SF4 has four sulfur-fluorine single bonds. So we write 2SF4 times four sulfur-fluorine single bonds. We also have one oxygen gas molecule as a reactant, which has an oxygen-oxygen double bond. So we add one oxygen molecule times one oxygen-oxygen double bond. That's all of our reactants. Next, we need to make the bonds of our products. We have two OSF4 molecules, and each OSF4 has four sulfur-fluorine single bonds and one sulfur-oxygen double bond. Notice that the two out front is applied to both four sulfur-fluorine single bonds and one sulfur-oxygen double bond. So we've used parentheses correctly. If we look at our Lewis structures closely, we'll see that the four sulfur-fluorine single bonds do not change from reactants to products. So in our equation, they show up as both being added from the reactants and subtracted from the products. These can be removed from the equation since they are not changing. The overall effect is that in our reaction, we are breaking one oxygen-oxygen double bond from the oxygen molecule and forming two sulfur-oxygen double bonds. When we're using bond energies to calculate enthalpy change, we can always break all the bonds of the reactants and form all the bonds of the products, and we should get the correct change in enthalpy. Or, if we are very careful, we can identify just what bonds are changing in the reaction, and we should get the same result if we correctly take into account coefficients in the balanced chemical equation. Now we can plug in our bond energies from the table. We have 1 mole of oxygen-oxygen double bonds, and the bond energy is 495 kilojoules per mole. We have 2 moles of sulfur-oxygen double bonds, and the bond energy is 523 kilojoules per mole. Completing the calculation, we should get negative 551 kilojoules for the change in enthalpy of the reaction. This is an approximation, since the bond energies in the table are only an average. The actual bond energies for a given bond depend on the context of the molecule.